How do we possess the promised life? God's promises. Guys, he is a promise keeper. But to be a promise keeper, that means he has to be the promise maker. Now, we can read in the Bible and see promise after promise after promise after promise of God. But when we talk about living the promised life, yeah, God's going to do his part. I mean, remember, he's the promise maker. But we have to do ours as well. I mean, think about it. We talked this last week about the story of Joshua. And when they got right there to the edge of the promised land, God's promise, God reminded him very boldly, what happened yesterday was yesterday. He said, Moses is dead. Now, go forward. Claim the promise. But it was up to him to lead forward. It was up to the Israelites to move forward and do what they had to do to claim that. So that's my challenge to you. No doubt God's made a promise to you in your life. No doubt his word is going to back that up, and that promise is going to be true. But guys, we have to do your part. Do your part. Maybe it means changing a little bit, doing something a little bit different. But whatever you do it moving forward. Don't turn around and look backwards. Our past is a big deal. I get that. We learn a lot from it, but that's what it's meant to be. Learned from, not lived in. You'll get stuck if you're continuing to turn around and look behind you. So look forward towards the promises of God. This has been a CPC Minute.